here. So we're out in Chandler, Arizona, and my buddy's got a $8.5 million mansion up for sale. Family friend of his owns it, and they use it for weddings right now, but city of Chandler has given them some hard times on utilizing it for weddings. So yeah, David's a good friend of mine. We're just gonna pop in and take a look at this amazing mansion here in Chandler, Arizona. David.
Somebody home?
So this is it.
Yeah, come on in. It's
built in 84?
Built 1984.
Is it original?
This is original. Yeah, there's been some modifications to the home.
How big is it?
The current owners put it back to its original state, all the paintings.
Okay.
That nature. So it's about 11,000 square feet with 10 bedrooms, 13, 14 bathrooms. It's crazy.
Insane.
I'll show you.
Wow, so you know the history of it.
Yeah. So, that's kind of the walk-in cooler.
Uh-huh.
But this is your ballroom, entertainment area. It's got a nice bar. So, but this has some awesome views to go out to the backyard. I'll show you more of that.
Sweet. But, so the original owner sold it to someone else?
Yeah, I don't know the real history on the original owner. Uh-huh. There's a couple owners in between that and our owner. So 1984, this was built up. One of the people that did own it covered that mural up and put something else there. And our current owner came and restored it to its original. But yeah, lots of stained glass, hand carved woods.
Are giant.
The kitchen, if you want to check out the kitchen over there, feel free. I'm going to turn a couple of lights on in the theater. And
cool. So, yeah, you can tell it's got the very dated granite here. These are kind of old school granite that we used maybe 10, 12 years ago.
Behind you is the eat-in kitchen.
Okay.
Call it, or eat-in breakfast room.
Yeah, I was wondering how you even figured out where the price is at, David. Probably a little tricky, huh?
Yeah, it's been a challenge. We had a lot of questions about the price.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, check out that TV, I think it was 1984.
Oh, that is sweet, yeah. Let's see, I was 15 back then. So I remember those TVs. So 10 and a half acres.
Oh yeah, it's about 10 and a half acres. It has its own, about 2 acres of a lake out front. So this is the...
That's sweet, it's got its own entertainment bar. And.
Right.
Oh, the theater room.
Theater room?
Check out these colors. I think my parents had this in the 1970s,
80s. And then this is an awesome room too.
Oh, the billiards. It's like your own little bar hangout. Yeah.
Yeah. Great.
This would be a awesome fun venue. Slumber party. Weekend hangout or a week hangout, a getaway, because it really doesn't feel like you're in city, especially outside there with all the land, and it doesn't feel like a neighborhood. So it's fully furnished, David?
Yeah, it's fully furnished.
So it's Airbnb, VRBO, but like you said, the noise maybe?
That's a pretty killer view. I think that's one of the best views in the home.
Yeah, that's sweet.
Just because you're going to get to look
at it. I love the trees that have been here for 40 years? I would say this would be a giant fix and flip for someone. Yeah.
A lot of stuff that you can change to like modern time now.
Oh, for sure. That would probably take about a year, I would imagine, planning and like really doing it upright.
So then you got
like a secret door or something?
Yeah. You guys can go up there and check it out.
It's like a playroom up here.
Oh, there's a couple rooms up there. Retreat area.
Holy cow, look at that ceiling. Yeah, a commission on this baby would be astronomical. How many people would fit in this house?
I know, there's probably...
Just keeps going and going.
Yeah.
Is there many $8 million homes in Chandler and Gilbert?
Not in East Valley, no.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like more Scottsdale area?
Yeah, Scottsdale PV, you find. Not really. Not on 8 acres land either. Most of them are on like 2 acres.
Oh, gotcha. So, yeah.
So yeah, this is the most expensive listing in, I guess, south of the 60 for sure. South of US 60 or...
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah. There's a big room there. This one's actually, this is the Victorian room with the other walkout. So someone might have slept in that bed. Who knows? But that's the other balcony. Another fireplace.
The Romeo and Juliet balcony here. Yeah, this would be even a bachelor party or like certain events, like you said, a venue.
Takes a little push.
Uh-oh, what's gonna pop out?
Other side. Right? Or pull it out.
This? Oh, there we go. Secret passage. It's like a movie. Check out the ceiling.
Is that a, like, secret room?
Yeah, they could film movies here, right? That'd be super fun.
Yeah, this director. I always thought this like a good music room, or some say it's a hideaway room, or
yeah.
Or to the there's two more rooms upstairs. You're more than welcome if you want to check them out. They're good sized rooms upstairs. I can show you those. Oh, these rooms are big. So keeping these rooms cool is in Arizona is probably as cold air sinks, you know, but not a lot of windows. This room sits over the carport.
It feels good in here.
Yeah, it does. This is a kind of a fun room. There's a little loft with three or four beds up there.
Yeah, it's crazy to think how many people could actually sleep in this house.
Yeah, and then back in the day when they built it, they had a family of, probably 4 or 5 kids, mom and dad, and so they were, you know, mom and dad, they're busy with the kids, and so they had an actual butler who lived at the house. So this is going to be the butler's quarters.
Oh, okay.
So it's like a house on its own. You got a kitchen.
Oh, yeah. You're in a different world here.
Yeah. Living room, no flat screen TV for them, just a fireplace.
Got fireplace.
Full bedroom in the bath. And then this kitchen is, if you go through it, you'll probably recognize some of these appliances are totally original.
Oh, yeah.
The toaster in the wall.
Oh, man. Haven't seen those since the
can opener in the wall.
80s. And is that the way to the garage or something?
That takes you down to the garage. So the butler, they'd have to go, you know, that door was probably locked. And the only way they'd come up would be through.
Oh, gotcha.
They'd come up through the garage. Depending on the time of day, this piece of stained glass has that night in it.
Okay.
And I guess it can cast off some pretty wicked shadows, and they would always call that the ghost shadow. Ah. It's an 8-inch slate. I think it's like 8-inch slate. Tile. This is a formal dining room.
Another fireplace.
And then we start off right here in the main house.
Gotcha.
What do you guys think?
It's amazing.
Can we flip it?
Flip it. I was talking with Isaac. It will be probably a year to 2 year project. I
mean, right.
Quite a bit of design that would need to get it updated. And
sure.
What do you think it was valued at, like back then when it was first made?
Oh, I would think around $2 million. I don't know, $1 million or something.
$1 million.
$84 million. I'm not sure.
Houses,
I was barely 10 or 80.
I wonder what, like houses you could buy for what, average house, what, 30 grand? Who knows?
Yeah, so
I don't know what they
so maybe millions on the high side. Well, I'm going to turn a few lights off.
Okay. Sweet. Well, thanks for the tour, David.
Yeah, you bet. You guys taking off?
Yeah, we're going to run.
Okay.
And
seeing you guys.
Definitely catch up when we come by the office.
Yeah, let's do it.